We are continuing our series of awesome intro tutorials. Howdy, VSDC fan! From this video, you'll learn how to create a splitting letterbox intro. Here's how it looks. Your logo appears in the scene, and then the background opens, revealing your video. Looks good? Let's get started. First of all, add your logo and place it in the center of the scene. Make a double click on it and add zoom from the video effects menu. In the properties window, find levels and switch the parameter change mode. Now, click on the three-dot icon. You'll see a trajectory on the timeline. On this trajectory, place control points on different levels, just like we're demonstrating, to achieve the jumping effect. Move to the main timeline tab and place the cursor at the end of the zoom effect. Time to bring text to the video. Use the T button from the left-hand side menu. Here, we'll apply formatting and place it to the left from the logo. Select the logo and the text and align them to the center. On the timeline, make a double click on the logo. Place the cursor at the end of the zoom effect and add movement using this green button on the left. Drag the movement vector to the left and set up the control points of the movement animation. Specifically, the first control point should be placed at the end of the zoom effect, and the second one should start in half a second. Let's go back to the main timeline tab and work with the text. Drag the layer to the beginning of the clip and click on it with the right mouse button. Convert it to sprite. Make a double click on the sprite, click on the text layer and place it to the left of the sprite zone. Make a double click on the text layer, then add movement. Drag the movement vector to the right, where the sprite zone is. Now, place the cursor at the end of the logo zoom effect. Also, place the first animation control point here. Move the cursor 1/4 of a second further and place the second control point right below the cursor. Our animation is ready, but you still can see the text behind the logo, right? Alright, let's go back to the main timeline tab and fine-tune sprite settings. In the properties window, deactivate the Use a container and the Fill background parameters by switching to No, then select Yes in the Show effects field. Select all the layers on the main timeline and reduce their duration to just a couple of seconds. Then, open the text sprite with a double click and add the fade out effect from the video effects menu. Repeat the same actions with the logo. Place the cursor at the beginning of the fade-out effect and add your video to a new layer below. Make a double click on the edit video and apply the wipe effect to it. In the properties window, find mode and select vertical out. Also, switch to true in the field named directly. Great job! If you have any questions, we'll respond to them in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye bye!